Hey guys, today we have this super clean E36 in the shop and we just built a custom stealth enclosure for it and sound system. Now when we're doing basic sound systems like this, they're pretty simple. And what we do is we just build the box to the specifications of the subwoofer. And you can see here I've got the line exact to the slant of the back of the firewall. That way it seals it. And that way we can project the subwoofer into the cab. And then you can see here, the customer bought two different amplifiers. I do prefer if the amplifiers did match, but that's what I was given. So what we did was we decided to make this as functional as possible. So you see the fuse holders over here, easy to service, our distribution block. And then we have our four channel, or it's actually a two channel over here, driving the front speakers. We removed the rear speakers, so we're sound staging this thing from the front with the subwoofer in the back. Up front, you can see that we have our Pioneer head unit. Looks very nice in the dash. Over here is the ski port, and that shows off our sub, and we carpeted this side black because all of this stuff over here is black, like the leather and everything. But you can see that the subwoofer is set back because the box is actually smaller than the actual overall dimensions because we need to hit a particular volume, and it just looks like it's supposed to be there. The next stage is we have to put a panel on here. So I built this panel out of, it's mainly one piece of wood, and then here is two pieces of wood where that way we can get some three-dimensional look onto it. And I'm thinking I'm gonna add another little piece in here to kind of cut it up a bit. This, you see, unless I get BMW carpet, this is the closest one I had, so it has a little bit of a two-tone effect onto it. You're not gonna notice it too badly, but if the customer were to get, you can, if you wanna get like really exact, you could get fabric from the manufacturers. This is all I had to pick from, so this is as close as I could get. I wish I could get a bit closer, but I'm pretty happy with how the fitment is and everything on this one. You see right now I'm just wrapping this panel that's going to go in there. I'm just trying to work it all the way in. I know it doesn't look like much, but it's almost done. And there you guys have it. Panel is all done. And nicely cut in the back. I like to work my wood. You guys know how much I like to work my wood. And I like, this makes life easier when you add little key features into a panel. That way I can just run my knife along it and it's a clean cut. I know no one's gonna see it, but it's gonna fit a lot better because my tolerances are very tight, so I don't want material gapping it out over here. I'd rather it just be the wood material over here. And yeah, this is gonna look nice in the car. Okay, so last minute details about the vehicle. What do we have? We have a Pioneer head unit up front. We have Alpine Type R speakers in the front stage. So we have woofers down low in the factory locations and tweeters up here. We also put sound deadening in. We have a JL Audio sub in the back with a JL Audio 2 channel driving the Alpine fronts. And then we have the Alpine monoblock driving the JL sub. I know it's a bit all over the place, but it works really well. Still, so you can still lift up this because it has a half on here where they've actually from factory they they made the material kind of lift up, so we can still grab the spare and everything. And then this cover over here comes off, and this accesses these batteries. So if you ever have to change the battery, you don't have to remove the sound system. You could just take off this cover and service the battery, whatever you need to do. Very functional. Well guys, there you have it. Another clean vehicle that has a stealth audio system that doesn't take up a lot of space, but still has the ability to give good sound and give functionality all at the same time. I love it when cars like this come in, because this car isn't expensive to pick up. It's still respectable, it's still comfortable, it handles great. Yes, it's not the fastest thing in the world, but you know, who cares? It's a good daily driver, and it's a lot better than I think than some of those like brand new compact cars out there that are kind of boring to drive. This is, even though it's an automatic, it's still kind of fun. And the best part is this car looks relatively stock. It's got all this gear in it, all this wiring that's done cleanly and run with all the factory wiring, especially along the door sills. And when we come up, we actually tied all the RCAs and everything with the factory harnessing. That way everything goes back together nicely. But you don't know that it has a sound system until you turn it on. And I think that's great. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram, Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca.